Dear Streamline, about your Twitch integration, where do I begin? It's over the top, almost like you're trying too hard for this to be a streaming game. It's rather annoying to set up a game with your friends when there isn't Steam inviting or even inviting with a link and having to sign up for a thing called Streammote. My experience with your game took 15 minutes just to get everything set up so I could play with two other people, which is ridiculous. This can be fixed, though, and I hope you plan to do so in a future update. The in-game features around Twitch are cool, but they're not super amazing. There's betting on winners, and viewers can spend points to apply certain effects to rounds. Most of the effects, though, just aren't fun or interesting. You have your pretty standard ice slow-mo, which I'm not sure why. This just doesn't seem the type of the game for it. You have this fast-paced, high-action tag-style game, and adding slow-mo just doesn't seem right. So that one just isn't my style for this. There are others, of course, but the bad ones when you get them are just draining. You feel like you have to bear through the times they're around. There's one called Pogo. I despise that one. Pogo makes everyone bounce constantly, which is really annoying when you're trying to pick up the orbs scattered around like a Pac-Man game. No Touching, though, is more of a fun one. I do have to congratulate you on that one. Not an original idea, but I think it does add to the game. Because No Touching makes it so if you touch anyone else, you die. Which is an extra layer of complexity. And my personal favorite, which I think is very fitting for this style of game, the floor is lava. Which is pretty self-explanatory. These extra rules don't add much to the tag style gameplay, which itself isn't super fun. Your attempts to change that were admirable, but they fell short. The wall running and parkour movements just aren't very usable and often slow me down to the point that I was better off without them. Attempting to run at a wall, run up a wall, run along a wall, and then jump off would halt all momentum. The most useful part of them was double jump. Because it's double jump, it allows you to jump you twice, which is super useful. And then we come to the punching mechanic. And this streamline is where I believe you have a choice to make. What are you trying to do? The punching mechanic is just not what I would have wanted with the style I believe you're going for, and it's just really buggy. I found myself swinging several times, either not hitting the person, or after completing the whole swing animation and my arm returning to its resting spot, and touching anyone within the next few seconds would stun them as if I had punched them. On other times, it wouldn't do anything at all. It was just buggy, and in the end, it drew away from your game. And that's a huge deal. I mean, the idea of being able to punch someone for points is great. But on top of throwing a stun, on top of that, is annoying. The ability to perma-stun people is absolutely possible. You can camp them and farm points off of them, which is not a good thing. I can imagine if you had more players in this, this wouldn't happen. But if you're not playing with a whole group of 16 people, you're having 3 or so, like I had, I would, as one of the runners, punch someone and keep them perma-stunned until the person who was it got there, and then run away, and they're still stunned, and then the person who is it would tag them. It's no fun. Even in every game, being stunned is no fun because you have absolutely no control. And so the ability to perma-stun completely removes the ability to do anything for a game. And this is why a punching mechanic that stuns, I don't think is a good idea. Now, the knockback on this, I think, is a pretty good idea. And it knocked them back a fair distance, which means perma-stunning them was a little hard, except you have a lunge on the punch about half the distance of the knockback. You could run, swing, knock someone back, walk for a second, and then punch again and hit them by the time they came back up, which would repeat the process. And it's even easier if you have them up against a wall. But the knockback mechanic is cool. I like it because on maps where you have places you can throw people off, like the skyscraper level, I think it's an absolutely spectacular idea. I think the ability to throw someone off, if you hit them right, is great. They have the chance to come back, is also something that is lacking. If you fall off the map, you're screwed. There's no way to climb up. If you miss your jump and you fall, and you double jump high enough that you come in line with a ledge, if the ledge grab does actually work, you might be fine. But I found myself a lot of times that I'd miss the double jump just slightly. Ledge grab wouldn't grab on, so I'd attempt a wall run, and then jump off the wall, and double jump back towards the ledge, which in theory would work. But double jump doesn't reset your momentum. So by jumping off the wall, and then double jumping, you're throwing yourself even farther away from the wall, somehow. Which means it is completely useless for scaling a lot of things. And there's not really any point in the map, in any of the maps I played, where wall running actually makes any sense to use. You're a lot better just running, jumping, and then double jumping over any of the obstacles. None of the walls were in the way, you'd go around them. And so, you're left with this lackluster experience. You come into the game, and having an extended setup process, after you've downloaded it off of Steam, around the first time installation, you still have to sign in through Twitch and Streammote. You have to actually have someone streaming just to play with them. Now, I was lucky, because Kermit is capable of streaming, but me and Austin can't stream. Our internets just aren't capable of it. And so here's a game that you're winning $20 for that I couldn't play unless I happen to have a friend who streams. So it all boils down to a few words. Good idea, just not good. It's a good idea, just not done right. And at a $20 price tag, I can't recommend your game. Even to streamers, I can't recommend it. If you go back and you fix some of the problems, which are absolutely fixable, I'll take a look at it again and reassess my evaluation of it. But at the moment, I just can't recommend this game. Signed, Airradda. Definitely an extra layer of complexibility. Complexibility, that's a word.